penalties at Oak Park, and that did not lead to success. I mean, they tried to be a pro team, and if you're going to be a pro team, you better have athletes. St. Paul's is a pro team. They want a multiple co-op.
Paul's going to make the first big move to see, of this game. Going for it on third and five, quarterback draw. L'Esperance with two great moves, and L'Esperance takes it inside the 20 down to the 15-yard line. A gain of 18 yards and a first down for the quarterback. He's had two great runs in this ballgame already.
Well, you know, every time I say something, they do the exact opposite. So, I mean, when I said this kid wasn't comfortable running, I guess he just wasn't comfortable running on us. He wanted to build some more yards.
For Drake L'Esperance. Right in front of the goalpost. It's up. And it's good. Drake L'Esperance, a 16-yard field goal. And the St. Paul's Crusaders trying to win their 40th consecutive football game. Takes it back to 43. Diakow fakes one way, tries to go inside. Now he cuts it back outside. He's got some room to run. Pulled down, finally, on the corner by number 20, Evan Lynn Keeley. Wolf and Oliver in the backfield. Wolf leads. Oliver's got a hole, and he's going to go down to the touchdown. Brady Oliver, 20 yards for the touchdown, and Oak Park has taken a 6-3 lead.
Wow. You want to see a hot knife through butter? Watch this play here.
What a great seal job by Wolf.
And through there he goes, and he
opened up a hole for Oliver. You could drive a truck.
Well, you're right on that one there. And then, you know, you got a couple offensive linemen who pulled through the gap there. You get a great down block by the center, and around the horn they come. That was
out of the gun now. Diaco with the same quarterback draw, and he's going to go nowhere. And Zach Berry is right there to shut that down. The middle linebacker, Dan Zach Berry, makes a great play. And that
great view of the
back to punt. Good punt by Dodd. Handled nicely by number 36, James Testchuk. He can't keep his footing here in the Investors Group.
St. Paul's offensive players step up and start generating some offense.
Hand off to Oliver. He's got nowhere to go, but he makes some room for himself. He gets outside, breaks the tackle, and he's got some room down the sidelines. He's pushed out at the 30. Cody Cranston had an opportunity to drop him for only a 2-yard gain. Couldn't make the tackle because those great big legs of Brady Oliveira ran right over him. His gain is 26 yards and a first down. There's the chance for Cranston. He can't knock down Oliveira, and Oliveira takes it down. 7-3 Oak Park leads it. This could put the Raiders up by a touchdown. Missing link the last time these two teams met. Defonte from 37 yards, it's up and it's good.
Great
that
kick.
Looked like a CFL field.
Excellent. You can tell he's a kicker too. St. Paul's all-star team here that they've got out there. I mean, all these kids could be.
And there's a fake by Diakow. He's got some running room and he'll have the first down. Diakow gets it to the 50. The fake by the quarterback. He's got a hole. Brady Oliveira cuts to the inside, takes it down. Diakow fakes the pitch. A little pass underneath Ellison, and he is home free. He will be caught from behind at the 1-yard line. But Andre Ellison takes the little flip pass underneath from Diakow, gets it down to the 1-yard line, and Oak Park is threatening to score again. What a great little pass by Ethan Diakow. Ellison had a step on both Cody Cranston.
Middle of the field is wide open.
Big Ryan Wolf takes it into the end zone for the touchdown, the final 1 yard. And Oak Park now leads it 16-3. Would you have thought that was going to happen?
No, not right now. I figured we'd be going 14-0 at the end of the game. Going into half. Tough, man. I don't know what to tell a kid on that one. Trevor Rice looks like this one here. He's going to carry some guys.
Offside, Oak Park. That'll be the fly.
No, here in the 30.
Les Bronson hands it off to Trevor Wright. He's got some blockers and some room. And Wright goes
on seven.
Third and seven. Les Bronson fakes, and he's hit. And the pass is caught. What a play. Coming back to the football. Number eight. First and goal from the nine. Trevor Wright has some room. He is stopped at the one.
Oh, we're going to go outside zone left here.
Les Bronson to Trevor Wright, and touchdown. There has been no signal yet. It looks like he's in, and they're saying no. They're going to mark him on the other side of the goal line at about the half-yard line, and now it's third goal. They'll mark it right at the one. Wright thought he got in. Let's have another look.
Well, you see, this is the problem with zone here. Everyone's lateral step, and it looks like the ref made a good call. He was down before he got in. Yard.
Third goal from the 1 yard line. Les Bronson takes it himself for a touchdown. Drake Les Bronson, the final yard.
No doubt on that play there. No doubt. Drake's going to pound his feet, follow those big uglies right into the back of the end zone there. You know, Canadian football game, that quarterback sneak is your most valuable weapon on third and short. No?
Back into the pistol. Four receivers on the right side. Dykel back to pass. He's looking deep. And it's picked off! A tremendous defensive play by number 20, Evan Lynn Healy. He has had an outstanding game tonight, and he picks one off just inside center field at the 53-yard line of Oak Park. What a tremendous play by Lynn Healy. And St. Paul's has possession three in Oak Park territory. Les Bronson, Trevor Wright, huge hole. Wright breaks it. He gets outside. Trevor Wright takes it down inside the 10 to the 7-yard line. What an effort by Trevor Wright. And St. Paul's now 7 yards. They're going on third down. Les Bronson is going nowhere. And he fumbles.
They fumbled again.
It'll be down at the 5-yard line. It's going to be marked down at the 5. And Oak Park holds. Trevor Wright is injured, and St. Paul's can't get it in.
Well, Wright's still favoring that left leg as I watch him walk down the season or the sideline. This is a busted play from get-go. I mean, I don't know what St. Paul's is doing here, but if it's a quarterback sneak, Les Bronson, Oliveira makes his money. He goes off tackle. He gets close to a first down, and then you get it on the next down.
They've given up the safety, and that's going to make it 17-15.
That'll be interesting.
Les Bronson looks for a receiver. There's nobody open. He found one. Sadro, first down. He had forever. Probably 15 steamboats back there. Sadro gets it inside the 5. They're inside the 20 and the 19. First and 10. 37, 36 seconds left. Les Bronson sets the offense. Drops back to throw again. He has some room underneath the Semchician. He's down to the 13-yard line. Gainus takes the snap.
Oh, threw it up!
Zone. Incomplete, what a great defensive play.
I'm going to put the dagger in your heart. That could have been that here.
10 seconds left, the 20-yard field goal. Les Bronson has already made one of these. The snap, the hold, the kick, it's up, and it's no good! It's wide! It goes for a single! 4 seconds left! Oak Park is going to win this ball game.
My Lord.
Les Bronson missed it left. And Oak Park, with 4 seconds left, will be the champions of the Potter Division. 17. And it's all over. And the Oak Park Raiders have stopped the 39-game winning streak of the St. Paul's Crusaders. The final score from Investors Group Field. The Oak Park Raiders 17, the St. Paul's Crusaders 16. And the Oak Park Raiders have won the Anavets Cup. They are the champions of the Potter Division. And my goodness, Doug Kovacs, who would have thought?
Well, I thought St. Paul's was going to take it over there, but they made so many mistakes in the second half that cost them there. The miscue on the goal line down there, on the other side down here. I mean, what do you say? Great football game, well fought. Oak Park, you know, deserving of the
champions. And the trophy, the Anavets Cup, from Commissioner Rick Hankowich to the Oak Park Raiders. They are the champions of the Winnipeg High School Football League's AAA Potter Division, and every right to be very, very proud of themselves.